Alright guys, welcome to Friday the 13th and our first night of three at HHN 29. It's a very exciting year. First thing up today, we are going to be doing Ghostbusters. From what I heard, this is it's going to be like walking through the movie. Man, Ghostbusters is just, it's a movie. I'm an 80s child and like, this is so 80s. I love it. Can't wait for this one. We're gonna hit this one up first. We'll let you know how it is. Oh my god, I am so incredibly excited for this one. So, let's go ahead and take it for a walk. So, we just did Ghostbusters, and I cannot remember a happier time going through one of the houses. This was just absolutely incredible. It hit every scene that I ever wanted to see in action. I think my only disappointment, this is going to be a spoiler-filled, so if you don't want major spoilers, you probably don't want to watch this, but this is our first impressions on every house, but we're going to present each house to you as we do them in order. So nothing is in any order whatsoever, just where we hit them and how we hit the lines, so we didn't have to wait very long for things. So Ghostbusters, just walking in, you got the music, you went through the library, you went through every scene that you really wanted to see in this movie. The basement, the fire station, oh my god, the top of the building with the Keymaster, and oh my god, it was just fantastic. Only thing I didn't really like was the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man. It was kind of like a projected thing, and I didn't think it looked all that great. The dogs, the demon dogs, oh man, those were excellent. The Ghostbuster actors, you didn't see them very often, at least we didn't, but when we did, they were very well done and really, really placed. Oh man, I just can't, it wasn't that scary, but I just can't remember a time where I've ever been that happy walking through and experiencing something. It really, really felt like it put you through the movie. I just recently did a Ghostbusters ride in Germany, and I thought that was going to be fun and great, and it was good, but this took it to another level. Absolutely fantastic. We got here right at opening, so we didn't have to wait very long, but right now, 50-minute wait, honestly, not that bad. If we didn't have other houses to do, we would definitely do this one again with 55 minutes. It was that good. All right, we're going to move on to something else. All right, next house. Us currently has a 20-minute wait, so let's go ahead and take it for a go. Second house today was Us, Jordan Peele. It's based on the movie. I am familiar with this movie. I saw most of it, missed some parts of it, but this house was very faithful to the movie. Had really good scares. Some of the sets just made you feel like you're right in the movie. Excellent. We did miss some of the scares, but we saw where most of them were. We don't feel like we got the full experience on this on our first reaction here, but definitely a really good one of the IP houses. We definitely want to check this one out later. We waited about 20 minutes. The line has now gone up, but not bad at all. It was kind of short. It does share the soundstage with Yeti, and this one feels shorter. So next up will be Yeti, so let's go ahead. All right, so we just got out of Yeti. That was very good for our first original attraction-based ride walkthrough. Really good scares, so many Yetis, and they did a really good job of scaring me. When I was distracted by something else, it's just like things like a Yeti arm would be right in front of me when I turned to look the other way. Some of the makeup on the lumberjacks who had their faces all gnarled up and all that stuff was really detailed, really disgusting, gruesome. Very good detail on some of those costumes. Absolutely enjoyed it. We missed a lot of scares on this one again. Sometimes that unfortunately happens, but we're gotten to the point now where we know where to expect scares or where the holes are. So again, another go-through on this one is very, very needed, but we really enjoyed what we saw so far and definitely want another go on this one. Next up is Nightingale Blood Pit. 35-minute wait. Let's hope it's not that long. It is 7:04. Let's go on to our fourth house and second original house. Just got done a Nightingale, our fourth house and second original. Themed to like Romans and these like creatures that are attacking them. And we waited, it was 35 minutes. We waited like.
We got out in 35 minutes.
We got out in 35 minutes, so that's not bad. Man, it just wasn't doing it for me. It has really tight corridors, really repetitive scenery in my opinion. We did have like girls that were screaming right in front of us, so it kind of gave away all the scares. But even when the scares were activating, they weren't very like in your face. Repetitive design on the creatures. It was gruesome. Again, these are first opinions, so we like to try things separate a second time. When we did Slaughter Simmons, we did that the first time, and we were like, eh. We did it a second time, we freaking loved it. So, you know, this is first opinions, and eventually we will do a review that will come out when we return to Philadelphia. All right. Next up is Depths of Fear. We'll read up on what this one is. I don't even know what this is. Obviously, water. All right, Depths of Fear. We walked in at 35 minutes, and it didn't take us nearly that much time. Really enjoyed this one. Very original. The theme is basically that you're a mining company that's underwater, and you're trying to get to escape pods as these monsters are attacking you. Really good sets. Really good lighting. Some water, actually, real water, actually tossed into the house. Good scares. Oh, man, it was really good. Some of the miners are actually kind of being transformed into these monsters as the deeper you go into the maze. Really good. I just really liked the atmosphere in that one. That really was, I mean, it was just like a night and day to Nightingale. Nightingale was just boring to me. And this one was just like, there was so much to look at and so much to take in. That's the one where I can't wait to see it again and take in more detail. Whereas Nightingale, I want to do it again just to validate my opinion, but like, I don't think I'm going to enjoy it much more a second time. I don't think I had a bad run. I think it's just not very good. Depths of Fear is definitely a thumbs up. That's one of the stronger houses. I don't know how I'm ranking them. Again, I'm not doing a ranking until a separate video. This is just first night opinions. All right, we're going to move on to House of 1,000 Corpses. Is that how many corpses we're going for? Okay, just on the other side of Men in Black. We're not doing any rides today unless we finish everything first. Because we have the annual pass this year, so we don't really need to worry about that stuff. Like last year, we didn't have an annual pass, so we wanted to do a few rides during our weekend. But that's not that important this year, which makes for nothing but horror. And let's look at some of this merch, man. Oh, that Ghostbusters shirt. Oh, that is so good. I kind of want that. But I don't know. All right. Next up, Rob Zombie's horror masterpiece, House of 1,000 Corpses. 40 minutes waits. It is 8:05. We'll see if it's actually that. Awesome exterior, let me say. All right. House of a Thousand Corpses, Rob Zombie. I feel like if we had seen this movie, this thing would make a heck of a lot more sense. It definitely felt Rob Zombie from like what I know of him. You know, it was a lot of rock music playing in the vein of him, and it was really cool. Like, I really enjoyed seeing what I was seeing. I'm not sure what I was exactly seeing or how the story progressing or if it follows the movie well. I don't even know if the movie's good. We're going to actually try to watch it before the end of HHN, so we had two nights that we could actually watch it after. I didn't hate it. I didn't love it. Kind of somewhere in the middle, and again, I think it's just for a lack of knowledge of the actual, you know, what it's based on. So, thumbs in the middle for this one. We'd like to try it again, especially if we get to see the movie before the end of our trip here. All right, we're going to move on. That is house number 6 and the third IP house. Pizza fries. I haven't had this in 2 years. I love the Den, and it looks fantastic. It looks way better. When I got 2 years ago, it looked a little overcooked. And then we went with a little bit of an upgrade with a chocolate shake. Really nice and refreshing on this humid night. So, Ariel, better than I remember them. What do you think, Ariel?
They're good. I like pizza. I like fries.
Yeah, it's a really good combination. Like, and I could totally make this at home easily for us. So. I think I said that last time, and I never have, so, yeah. All right, so we're going to finish this up and then do the two houses by here, which is
Graveyard,
and then the Universal Monsters, which I'm very excited about. All right, last original house to do tonight for HHN 29, Graveyard Games. Let's go check it out. 50-minute wait. Somehow I doubt we'll wait that much because all the waits have been a little bit overestimated. And Ariel did not like this last night. She was able to come because I got stuck in Paris and do half the houses last night. And this was your least favorite, basically? Okay. So, all right. No E.T. Aww. Alright, so we just did Graveyard Games. This one wasn't that great. Probably my second least favorite of the group, with the Roman theme one being my least favorite. I had an interesting story with like teenagers like vandalizing a graveyard, and then the spirits, they said spirits, coming back to haunt them, but the spirits just looked like zombies or something. And it had a really good entrance, like really big, like, you know, like two-story, like mausoleum looking, like, you know, graveyard structures. Looked really cool, but after that you just looked like you were going through a lot of mausoleum type areas, and it was repetitive, and the scares were okay. I don't know. Again, I'll give it another try, but This one's not so hot, in my opinion, so far. So hopefully it gets better with the second go, but I don't think it's going to impress me much more. So you kind of know these things now. Scares were okay, but not amazing. All right, so we're going to go ahead and do the Universal Monsters next. This is one of my top three anticipated of the trip, along with Stranger Things and Ghostbusters. So really excited for this. Our waits are always been exaggerated, so we should be done this within 50 minutes. Alright, so it's getting late. These waits were our longest. They've now died down quite a bit, but these were our longest waits of the night at nearly 2 hours to do both of these. So these were definitely a speed bump. We got done with the Universal Monsters. You know what? It didn't blow me away, but it was a really, really cool. Just, you went from room to room from one different classic monster to another. I mean, I'm not going to list them all, but it covered pretty much everything. I think my favorite scene was Frankenstein. That was really done well. Frankenstein, like, he totally creeped on Ariel, like, followed her a little bit. And then there's a second Frankenstein that scared me, and I think scared her too. But other than that, I mean, all the scenes were really done well, and for the most, I mean, everything was high quality in that. That was fantastic. We definitely want to try that again. It's really good for the tribute and the novelty of that one. I loved it.
Worse, I have turned mankind into a monstrosity, and now my own metamorphosis is imminent. The monster that lives within me.
This is Vanity Ball, which, very sexy theme, and that, oh, okay, this seems like they're lively here.
Thank you.
Songs from Outer Space. We watched the movie recently. We loved it, so we were very excited, especially after that Scary Zone last year. We are very excited for this one. Hopefully that sounds a little exaggerated. It was 45 minutes, like 5 minutes ago, so we'll see how it goes. I don't think it'll be that bad. This location's kind of been eh for me. First year was Seoul, and that was okay. Last year was Halloween. That was okay. I have high hopes for this one. I think it will be, yeah. You've seen this one? Yeah, yeah. So, let's see how this one goes. Killer Clowns from Outer Space. We did not wait 65 minutes. We waited a little bit less than that. Absolutely fantastic. Loved it. Followed the movie pretty well. You started with some of the scenes from, like, the shadow puppet scene and all that stuff. And then you kind of just went into a fun house, like, kind of the spaceship area. I was hoping for a little bit more locations from the movie. Scares were okay. I didn't really get that scared. I don't feel like the big clowns are really able to lunge very far. I had one scare where the floor actually like vibrated really hard. I think they dropped something, and it that got me really good. As far as set designs go, you know, it kind of felt like a fun house. You had the room where all the cocoons are. That was pretty good with the smells and all that. It was enjoyable. I really enjoyed it. I definitely want to try this one again. It was a nice expansion to the Scare Zone last year. Good IP house. Definitely enjoyed it. All right, let's go check out Anarcade. Impressions of Anarcade, like really simple scare zone, but way better than what they've had the last 2 years. It's kind of been a mix from each scare zone to be like a selfie zone. I much prefer that to what they've had. Plus the arcade motif looks awesome with the oversized arcade machines. Really cool. I suppose they probably jump out from those arcade machines since they're empty. We weren't doing that when we were walking through, but it looks awesome. I loved it. So far, I thought the scare zones were a little weak this year. Once it got dark and these things come alive, like usual, really enjoy the Vanity Ball, really enjoy Anarcade. This one, so-so, it's okay. Don't love it, don't hate it, it's fine. also had this recreation of SNS Shot Tower, and it kind of looks stupid, but I guess it's okay. This is always like the stage scare zone. Let's check out the tribute store. We loved it last year when it was themed to Stranger Things. Let's see what it's themed to this year. Oh, Ghostbusters. Duh. Oh yeah, this is cool. Look, you got the chamber right here. That's cool. So the second part is Stranger Things theme. Demodog right here. Shirt, Centipede, Atari, Asteroid, and that cool scene. Very, very cool. Alright, and here's the third room. So they expanded it this year, made it a little bit bigger. Not sure what this is one really themed to. It looks nice. Alright, it's about a half an hour before close. Hopefully this doesn't happen to be an 80-minute wait. Stranger Things, continuation of the popular one last year, with Stranger Things 1 and 2 represented in this one, not just the first season, one season like last year. Very, very looking forward to this. We didn't save this for last for a reason. We saved it because it's just very popular. Alright, let's go. Final house. We're getting all 10 of them done today without Express Pass. So I would say that's really good considering our opening night of last year, we got like, what, 5 houses done or something like that? Maybe 6? It was bad. So this has been a much better first night for me. Ariel's kind of first night. She had a preview night last night, we'll call it, right?
Yep.
Yeah. So Stranger Things. Season 2 and 3.
Hey, did you get a...
It was good. It didn't like blow me away like the first season. I think that just was because it was the first time. As far as the quality of everything, I think it was a little bit of a step down from last year. Especially the one scene where they're trying to seal the portal, and it was just the two dummy characters on top of the platform. Yeah, that looked garbage, in my opinion. And there were some good scares. Some of the casting was fine. Some of it just didn't seem right. Like, I had to stare at it for a second, be like, what character? Oh, yeah, it's that character. Or we had to actually, like, come along to more than the same character like a second time for me to finally figure it out. All right, so as far as the story arc of the house containing both seasons, it picks some of the more memorable scenes on it. I feel like you'd be very, 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 very confused if you hadn't seen both seasons. Because it jumps around, and it doesn't really include that much of season 3, to be really honest with you. I enjoyed it. Not as good as last year. Definitely not my favorite house. But I digress. It's been a great night. The event's very good. I think I like last year's lineup a little bit more, actually, better. But still, very, very good. So let's go over that arch and close it off for the evening. That's going to be it. Thank you so much for watching. We will have a review and a list of the houses from 1 to 10 and the scare zones. So look for that later this week. Thank you so much for watching. This has been Alex. You know what to do. See you soon.